He said that verse 8, he said, but the sheep did not hear them. In other words, the church folk didn't understand what was going on. I am the door, he says it again, the door of opportunity. By me, if any man, if any church person, any individual come in, enter in, he shall be saved. That word saved means rescued, preserved, and healed. If you need to be rescued from anything in life, if you need to be healed from anything, any situation or circumstance, if you need to be preserved, he said, I'm the door to that. I am the door to the opportunities for perseverance, preservation, healing, and rescuing. And he goes on to say, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pastor. Ooh, watch this. Now, the preachers who preach against prosperity preachers say that God, the Lord Jesus, is all about salvation and salvation only. He's not about you having a good car and about a nice home and job. He ain't about all that. So you prosperity ministers, you're trying to fleece the people. That's what they say. Y'all ever heard this before? Watch this. See, when you know the word, you understand that what they are saying is in error. It is wrong. Watch this. I'm going to show you something. Jesus said himself right here, he says that I am the door, and by me, if any man, some men, if any man, saved man and unsaved man, if any man come by me, the door of opportunity, he shall be saved. If he comes through me, I'm going to save him. And he shall, the man that comes through me and gets saved, that man will be able to go in and find pastor. And go out and find pastor. What is pastor? The word pastor is a Greek word nome, which means growth, increase, and prosperity. It means prosperity, growth. That means you're developed. You're move up. You're gain more than what you had before you came through the door of opportunity. You will increase, you will get more than what you had before you came through the door of opportunity, who is Jesus. And you will prosper. You will be moving and doing things that the people around you can't understand how you're doing it. Because you will be doing it at such a level that they just can't see how you're driving that white Mercedes, Sister Glenda. I don't know how they doing that. Ain't their business.
Right.
But they don't need nothing. They don't need no money. So we don't need. That's not your business. You tithe, and God bless you with a Mercedes. Lord have mercy. Did y'all get that? The pastor is growth, increase, and prosperity. And he says that they will find growth. That word find means they will learn. They will discover, especially after searching. So when you come in where? Come in through the door into the church of God, and you receive the word of God, you will discover, you will learn. As a result of learning the word of God, you will grow, you will increase spiritually in your knowledge, you will learn what the word of God has to say about what it is you should do, and then you will go out. That means outside of the church, into your neighborhood, and you're going to grow in your neighborhood. You're going to grow on the job. You're going to prosper. Your bank account is going to prosper. Your house is going to prosper. Your home is going to prosper. Your children is going to prosper. Your life is going to prosper. Jesus was a prosperity preacher. Man, there are some people, they think they are so smart. So I don't have to believe ignorant folk who tell you that you can't prosper in the scripture. And Jesus just sat right there and just told you that you come in the church and prosper, and then you're going to leave out of the church and you're going to what? That's prosperity. That means money. That means fine jewelry, good clothes. That means health and wealth. That means all the things that you can imagine according to godliness. I have given you all things for godliness. And then he goes on, he says, watch this. Shall go in, shall go out to find pastor. I'm going to show you another point on this. The way that that is written, because I looked it up in the Greek, I said, how is this written? What is the tense? So this is the importance of taking Greek class. This helps you. This text, this line, this verse is written in the future imperative middle tense. The future imperative middle tense. Mother Brazil, here's what that means. See, that sounds like a bunch of sophisticated words. So that's why you go to school and you be able to break future imperative middle tense. Because that don't make no bunch of sense. Here's what it means. It means I'm talking about your life in the future. Future. Imperative means facts. In other words, it is a fact that in the future, here's what's getting ready to happen for you. The word middle tense means that it's, watch this. Now, this is going to blow somebody away because you're going to get this. The word middle tense means that it is self-serving. Mother, what's your name? Sister K, I'm going to preach to you. It means that it's self-serving. So what Jesus did in that verse, he says, in the future, like now and in the future, it is a fact that if you come here to Faith Temple and receive the word of God that this man is putting out, that you will not only grow here but and prosper here spiritually, supernaturally, but that you will be able to leave the doors of this institution and go out into your community, to your job, and into your family. And you're going to grow and prosper. And not only are you just growing and prospering, but you are doing it for self-serving purposes. You're doing it because you need it. what y'all been taught. The thief is the devil. The devil comes to steal. That's not talking about the devil. It's a similitude of the pastor that has not come through the door. That has not been sent by Jesus. I'm dropping the key. There you go. That's who I am. He has come in and he's a stealer of the tithe and the offering. He said the thief come but to keep, but to steal. And then he says, to what? To kill. That word kill means to sacrifice the people of God. The thief comes and he sacrifices your life. He steals your money, your tithe and offering, or the tithe and offering that belong to God. And he sacrifices you. Now, why is he sacrificing you? What do people that do sacrifices, what's that about? It's witchcraft. The pastor that does that is a warlock. And he's in league with Satan. And what he is doing is he is stealing from you to take what you have and to leave you in a destitute position. He's sacrificing you to gain increased power with the devil. Because the more he can harm you, the more powerful he becomes in the kingdom of Satan, in the kingdom of darkness. So he sacrifices your life so that he can increase. Did anybody get that? And finally, that's to kill and then destroy you. He wants to annihilate you. Annihilate you emotionally. Annihilate you physically, so you'll be drained. So you'll be torn down intellectually. So you'll be torn down financially. And if you keep on reading that script, you'll see where then, as he sees the wolf coming, he then flees because he's a hireling. He's been hired by the church. That kind of pastor has been hired by the church to preach him a good sermon. But then after he done destroyed the folks of God and tore down that church and then messed that church up, where you at, Brother Felton? And he done caused all kind of conflict and disarray within the household of God. And he got people confused and he got people discombobulated. I don't hear you. Hit that organ for me, brother. Don't play with it. Hit it. Come on, hit it. Hit it from me. All right. So then he says, but you know what? Give me a full chord. There you go. He says, but I want to let you know that I'm not leaving you by yourself. Wait till I finish getting depressed. I want you to know. I want you to know. That's what I want right there. Keep doing that. That even though, stay with me, the thief may have come to steal, to kill, and to destroy, but I want you to know.
one is there one today that want to surrender your life to Christ? You want to be saved today? You want to accept Him as your Lord and Savior? Salvation's free. Very simple process, but very, very meaningful. We all must accept Christ if we want to see His face in peace. We want to hear Him say, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant." Is there one today that want to give your life to Christ? Come to the altar. Let us pray with you. The Lord will say,
"Hallelujah!
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus." Is there one? Hallelujah. We thank God for you. You may be seated. We thank God for you. We thank God for Dr. Kemp. Amen. And today, the word of God that we have heard. Please hold on just a second. Amen. Deacon Coffin, come back. I need you. Amen. What I want to do real quickly. Yes, bring the offering pan. Let's get a love offering for Dr. Kemp. Let's get a love offering. Amen. Amen. He's not preaching for an offering, but we want to just be a blessing to him. Is that all right? Is that all right? Amen. Amen. You just must go. Just leave your offering at the table there. But we thank God for the word, and we just want to show a little love. Amen. Spread a little love. Show a little love. Amen. Amen. Just everybody, just stand to your feet. Whatever you have to give in this offering. Amen. Stand to your feet.